Welcome back to Sunday Brunch Live. We're here with free diver Ian Donald. Welcome to the show. Tell us a bit about yourself, Ian.
So I run FreediveUK down in Cornwall, where we teach people how to hold their breath for excessively long periods of time, basically.
And is that fundamentally what freediving is?
Yeah, in a nutshell. So you're kind of going beyond what you think you might be capable of doing as far as breath hold goes, deeper than you might think you might be able to do. Same sort of depths that scuba divers do, but with half the equipment.
How's the how is the free diving scene in the UK? Is
it? It's pretty active. There's lots of clubs in, you know, all the major cities, and then along the coastline, lots of people doing it every day. It's growing, certainly.
Is there any point to it? Aren't our waters dark and cold and scary?
Well, on the whole, no, thankfully.
Is that in our water?
That is. Really? That's just off Cornwall there. So it does get nice and clear. You know, it's not that kind of shopping trolley, dirty water that people always expect. You know, it can be absolutely beautiful.
But is it seasonal?
It is seasonal. I mean, our season runs from May to the end of September, and then we go away in nice warm places when it's too cold over here.
How dangerous is it in comparison to scuba diving?
I'm a little biased, but I say less. The reason is it's completely self-regulated, all right? So you're not having to worry about a cylinder being filled badly or some equipment failing. You are the equipment. So as long as you know what you're doing and you've had some training and someone's with you, it's actually very safe.
How long can you go under for?
So if I'm just on the surface without doing much, I can hold my breath for about 7.5 minutes. The world record there is about 11.5 minutes. But that obviously changes. As soon as you start moving around, times go down.
So that's the bit I don't get, right? So you think to yourself, right, 7 minutes, you say, so you think to yourself 6 minutes.
Right, OK,
right,
yeah.
It's taking you 30 seconds to get down.
Yeah.
And then you're under there for 5 minutes or so.
OK, yeah.
And then you think, I've moved around too much, I've run out of air, and I've only got 10 seconds left, but I've got 30 seconds to get back up.
Yeah. Well, you try and gauge it a bit better than that, and you'll just... It's a progressive sport, you know? It's like you just move into it gradually, so...
Are you busy on the...
Yeah, so, I mean, like...
Can you feel it in here?
It's mostly in here. You can use a dive watch and kind of think about your times a bit, but it's best not to focus too much on things like that. It's just about what you're feeling, and then, yeah, you just gauge it gradually and work it out.
And you've got to train, haven't you, to do it? It's not something you can't just kind of take a chance. You need to be properly...
No, you do. I mean, one thing I'd say to everyone who wants to give it a go is go find a school, go find a club, get some training in. But then it's really accessible. So you can do it in the cities, you can do it on the coast. Doesn't really matter what age you are, what background, physicality. It's really, really open.
And how deep can you actually go?
So the world record for a no-limits dive, so that's kind of being dragged down with, like, a heavy sled and being brought back up again, is 214 metres. Recreationally, we might talk about 40 metres being kind of, like, a comfortable zone for people to be diving up to.
Does it hurt? Because when you go under, do the compression start hurting your head?
Yeah, it shouldn't hurt. If everything's working properly, it shouldn't hurt. We learn to equalise those pressures a bit, so... Yeah, it's actually quite comfortable when you're down there until you get to a certain depth, then it feels a bit like you're getting squashed.
What happened? What's actually happened to your body then?
So, I mean, basically, we go through various pressure changes as we're going down. I'd say, like, in the first 10 metres or so, you start to compress. You actually half in size in lung volume. Then as you get deeper, you start to sink. Your heart rate starts to drop. Blood starts flowing from the limbs into your core to keep you going for a little bit longer. By the time you're at 40 metres or beyond, you're so compressed that it feels like there's no air left in your lungs and like someone's squeezing you really tight. And then on the reverse, everything kind of happens the other way around and just take it easy on the way back.
Because you've said this before, which quite surprised me, that your body is actually trying to make sure that you succeed, where I would always imagine that it would try and make you fail.
No, like, we are designed in some ways to freedive. There's something called the mammalian dive response that helps us do this. So there's lots of technical things that are happening inside your body which will actually really help. Ultimately, the body's always striving to survive, whatever way you look at it. So you've just got to embrace it and kind of move into it a bit, and it works really well.
Have you ever had your body tested?
Since
you've been doing it a long time.
I've been doing it a long time, yeah. And you'll find that freedivers who have been doing it a long time have higher hemoglobin levels, an enhanced lung capacity, an ability to deal with lower oxygen levels. So it does transfer to other sports as well, which is quite handy.
And can we all learn to do this?
Yeah, 100%. 100%, yeah. It's how, you can do it anywhere, that's the thing. I mean,
how long would it take me to get up to 3 or 4 minutes underwater or something?
We do. In a day, we get people up to about 2 minutes. I'd say within a week, you'd be over 3 minutes for most people. And then 4 minutes, yeah, easily within a month or so.
And the technique for getting someone up to 2 minutes is just don't panic, or is there actual technique?
There is technique. Right. It is mostly don't panic. Right. It is mostly don't panic. The main thing that makes you want to breathe is lots of carbon dioxide in your bloodstream. So that's the kind of the trigger. And so we have to learn to kind of push through that. And that's where the training is.
We've got a bit of equipment here on the table. Yeah. This one here is like intriguing for us. Yeah. What's that?
So you've got a monofin. So that's a carbon fibre monofin. So that's where all the depth records, you know, take place. So using something like that, you get a lot of power. So the deepest someone's been with someone like that is about 129 metres, I think. That's one style. Then you've got bifins like this, so two separate fins on each foot, still carbon fibre, really long, much longer than you might have used snorkelling or something. So again, you get tons of power out of something like that. You need a wetsuit in the UK in particular, obviously, as you go abroad. I mean, if you train somewhere nice and warm, all you actually need is a mask and your swimsuit.
Is it a bit like meditation when you're down there?
Yeah. It is.
Because I imagine it goes very quiet.
Yeah, it's very quiet. You're on your own. I mean, there'll be someone watching, but you're essentially on your own. Yeah, it's just this kind of peace that you get from it, which I think attracts a lot of people.
Yeah, feels like that. Right, so you do a lot of training. Is it right? You do a lot of your breathing training out of the water.
Yes, so you can... Obviously, you can't be in the water the whole time. So there's lots of stuff you can do on dry land, and it tends to enhance your training a little bit as well, because it's actually harder on dry land than it is to do in the water sometimes.
And people are using this training, bizarrely, I was telling you earlier, I downloaded an app, I didn't know you were coming on the show, because people are saying it's very good just for normal life to do this sort of... But athletes are using it, aren't
they? Athletes are using it now, pro coaches are using it now. It's kind of, it's used in conjunction with altitude training a little bit, so you can get the same kind of benefits, but just, you know...
How long would you do a session for, then?
I mean, training sessions can last anything from about an hour to about 3 hours. So, like, in a three-hour session, compared to what you might see scuba diving, you'll see about the same amount of stuff if you're actively diving.
Okay. We want to do a bit of training. Simon's got to put in a lot of shifts in a kitchen sometimes. Needs as much as he can, lung capacity. So we're going to do a bit of training, and Simon's going to hold his breath.
So what do we do?
OK, right. So normally it takes a bit
longer.
Can we
just say, by the way, if you do this, you shouldn't go into water straight afterwards because you can black out. Be with a pro if you're going to...
Always be with somebody. You do a couple of minutes of nice chilled out breathing. So just for the moment, just take a few relaxed breaths, okay? Exactly. Then we just go through three movements of air, right?
Okay.
So what you want to do, take a breath slightly deeper than you might normally take, right? Then push it all out, right? Really punch it out, exhale everything. That's it. Then breathe in, start from the belly and just kind of work your way up through your chest. And you want to take as deep a breath as possible till it feels pretty uncomfortable, actually. That's it. And then just last grab. Right. So the idea now is you've got to try and relax, OK? You don't want to use any muscles that you don't need to be using. Just zone out. Don't think of anything. Brain uses a little bit of oxygen, so you want to cut that out. And this is it. Now you're stuck.
That's not good training. You made me laugh. Yeah.
This is where the focus comes in, you see. Clearly, we've got Zen focus over here. That first urge to breathe, that's the carbon dioxide starting to flood. Okay, and that's what people find hard to get through at first.
Are you feeling like it's hurting at all?
Yeah.
Are you panicking inside? A little bit. Yeah. Yeah.
Doing all right, though.
He's doing all right. What's he at?
So he's at just under 47, 48 seconds.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
He's a contender.
And then right at the end, when it really starts to hurt, your diaphragm starts to contract. It feels like you want to keel over, but then we go even further.
Sadly, we've run out of time. Not sadly for us, but not sad for Simon.
Yeah.
Thanks, Ian. To find out more, the British Freediving website has all the info. In a moment, we're chatting to director Edgar Wright. But first, here's what's still on the menu.
It's going blue.
Today's show.